Let's solve together our next related rates problem, this one that has a subtlety where we need to be careful not to go wrong. A 1.8 meter tall man walks away from a 6.0 meter lamppost at the rate of 1.5 meters per second. The light at the top of the post casts a shadow in front of the man. How fast is the head of his shadow moving along the ground? We'll again use our four-step problem-solving strategy for related rates problems to tackle this, since it works every time. We first draw a picture. We have the ground and a lamppost, and we'll put a lamp that's orange at the top of the post. Some of the light that leaves the lamp strikes the ground, thereby illuminating it. When there's a man standing there, the light that hits his back doesn't reach the ground, thus producing a shadow in front of him. The shadow goes from his feet to a point that's determined by the line that passes from the lamp along the top of his head and then onto the ground. Since we're really only interested in the shadow, let's focus on that along with the line that determines its length. The man is 1.8 meters tall, and the lamppost is 6.0 meters tall. Let's call the distance from the lamppost to the man, x, and the distance from the lamppost to the head of his shadow, l. Now we're making a choice here where you need to be careful, and almost no one talks about this subtle point. We're measuring everything using the lamppost as the origin, as if we've painted a coordinate system on the ground. This coordinate system doesn't move when the man walks, which is what we want. By contrast, a common error is to draw your figure like this, and without really thinking about it, measure the position of the head of the shadow from where the man is standing. That seems reasonable, but what you don't realize is that with this choice, you've attached the coordinate system to the man's feet. Then when the man walks, the coordinate system moves with him, and so we're not measuring how fast the head of his shadow moves along the fixed ground. It'd be like carrying a ruler with you while you're measuring how fast the tip of your shadow is moving, which you, of course, don't want to do. So instead, we measure everything from the fixed position of the lamppost. Now with that choice, let's think about what the problem is telling us. As the man walks, his x position changes at the rate dx dt, the rate at which x changes with respect to time t. We're looking for the rate at which the position of the shadow's head moves along the ground, which is dl dt, the rate at which L changes with respect to time t. Now clearly, the faster the man walks, the faster the head of his shadow moves too. That is, the larger dl dt is. The rates dx dt and dl dt are thus somehow related. Our job is to find that relationship. Specifically, we're told that the man walks at 1.5 meters per second, which is the value of dx dt. And we're looking for the corresponding value of dl dt, the rate at which L changes. We need, then, to find the relation between dl dt and dx dt. To find that, we back up a step, and first must find a relation between L and x. And that takes us to the second step of our problem-solving strategy. Write an equation that relates the quantities of interest, in this case, between L and x. As you know, if you've watched our other videos, in any related rates problem, you'll use one of four approaches to complete this step. We cover each of them in the free materials on our website. For this problem, to develop the equation we need, we'll use similar triangles. What makes us think of similar triangles? In our figure, we see one small triangle embedded in another bigger triangle, which is a big clue that we'll use similar triangles in our solution. Notice that here, both the small triangle and the large triangle are right triangles. Furthermore, the upper angles of the two triangles are equal, and the base angle is actually identical in the two triangles. Since all three angles in the two triangles are equal, the triangles are similar, and so we can develop a relation among their lengths, an approach you'll use often in solving many related rates problems. To do so, remember that the man's height is 1.8 meters, which we'll add to our small triangle, and the lamppost's height is 6 meters, which goes on the large triangle. The base of the large triangle has length L, while the small triangle has length L minus X. With those quantities in place, we can remember that when you have similar triangles, the ratio of their base lengths equals the ratio of their heights. Here, the ratio of the base lengths is L minus X divided by L, which equals the ratio of their heights, 1.8 meters divided by 6.0 meters. Numerically, that equals 0.30. We can now solve for L in terms of X with just a little algebra. We first move L from the denominator on the left over to the right, so we have L minus X equals 0.30 times L. Then collecting all of the L's on the left and moving X to the right, we have L minus 0.30L equals X, or 0.70L equals X. And that's it. That's the relation we need between L and X. And so with that, we're now done with the second step of our problem-solving strategy, since we have that relation. And so we move on to step three. Take the derivative with respect to time of both sides of our equation. Starting with the left-hand side, we have ddt of 0.70L, and that equals ddt of X. Now on the left, we can pull 0.70 out of the derivative since that's a constant, and so we have 0.70 times ddt of L, but that quantity is the rate dL dt, the quantity we're looking for. Similarly, on the right-hand side, ddt of X is the rate dx dt, which equals 1.5 meters per second, a substitution we'll make in a minute. For now, this completes the third step of our strategy, because we now have the relation between dL dt and dx dt that we need. Our fourth and final step is to solve for the quantity we're after. We want dL dt, so let's divide both sides of the last equation by 0.70 to get dL dt equals 1 over 0.70 times dx dt. We know that dx dt equals 1.5 meters per second, so we can make that substitution. And numerically, 1 over 0.70 times 1.5 meters per second is 2.1 meters per second. And that's it. Our final answer is 2.1 meters per second. As you can see, the calculus in this problem is quite straightforward and just involves taking some very simple derivatives to go from the relation we develop between L and X to the relation between their rates of change. The challenging part for everyone just starting out is to practice enough problems, like the ones we have on our website, to spot and then use similar triangles in a problem like this one that calls for that approach, or to use a different approach as required. We promise that with practice, you can learn this skill. Here's a summary of the steps we used to solve this problem that you can screen grab if you'd like. We use these same four steps to solve every related rates problem we encounter, and you can too. You can download this problem-solving strategy for yourself and see many more calculus problems with completely worked out solutions at our website, mathno.com. Please also subscribe to our YouTube channel, and you can immediately go to a video solution of another related rates problem, one with a different twist. For now, please let us know the questions you have or any suggestions. We'll do our best to help.